Hey everybody, Jeff Waters here from lifeupfront.com. My old colleagues back at CFdesign sent me an advance copy of their upcoming release, CFdesign 2010. Now, if you've been around CFdesign for a while, you'll recognize that that's a naming change, pretty drastic naming change. Went from V7, V8, V9, V10, and no V11. It's now 2010. And I think it's a fitting time to make a big name change like that, considering what they've packed into this software package. There are some big changes to the workflow that you're used to in the past, but I think they're good changes and quite intuitive changes. So new users coming along are going to find this even easier than before to pick up, and old users are going to have to learn a couple of new tricks, but overall I think they'll be real happy. So I thought I would take everyone here through a real quick example of the workflow in 2010 as I understand it at my first glance. So as usual, you need to run CFdesign with some geometry, and I've started by building this simple car in SpaceClaim. And this is like a Pinewood Derby analysis that I decided to do. Imagine you take a Pinewood Derby car and scale it up to full size, run it at 60 miles per hour in a wind tunnel. That's what we're going to do. So the first thing you'll notice here is you're confronted with the Design Study Manager. And this is all new in 2010. It introduces the concept of a design study, a design, and a scenario. As you'll see a little later here, those play a big role in how you're going to do your workflow in CFdesign 2010. You'll notice right off that there are some big changes in the user interface. First, we're not going to concentrate on the vertical row of icons as in the past. Instead, you're going to use directly this structure tree for editing and setting up your model. And while that may be a shock for some existing customers at first, I think you're going to find it's a really, really quick way to work. So for example, first step here, we're going to set some material properties. Turn that into air. And you can box select all the parts here, or one by one, and just directly start to edit what these materials are. I find these windows to be a nice move away from the panel system. Though if you do prefer the panel, or what's called the control bar, that's still at your fingertips, and I'll talk about that in a minute. Same thing with boundary conditions. You can just pick directly on the geometry now and choose whatever boundary condition makes sense, 60 miles per hour in this case, through our wind tunnel. And we'll specify an exit pressure here as well. So one thing I want to point out right now is the space bar. The space bar is going to be your friend in 2010. It toggles between the control bar and the design study bar. So when you go back to the control bar, you'll see more of a standard V9, V10 look and feel. Or you can go back to the design study bar just by clicking the space button. So use the space bar a lot. And of course, I'm just going to choose automatic sizing, but you have all the control you've come to expect from CFdesign. Now, when it comes time to solve, you can go again into the traditional solve menu, which is starting to get quite a few options in there, and you can click the solve button, or what I think most people will do is go to this top right solve button. And it's like a mini solve window that pops up based on the settings that you've already prepared. I kind of like this better myself, and I think that's what most people will use once they decide what class of problem they're solving. Now, as your analysis takes off, you can, of course, go in and look directly at the results. You're going to see some really, really cool improvements in the results. I'm not going to focus on a lot of that for this review. I have a feeling that the folks at CFdesign are going to do a much better job of me at that anyway. But here's some of the common things you might do. Look at velocity vectors in this case, or velocity profiles. And you can move that cutting plane around wherever you like. And keep in mind, this is all happening while it's actually crunching the numbers for the solution. Now let's get into the big news in 2010, and that is design studies. Big improvements here. So as I mentioned before, we've got the concept of a design, a scenario, and a design study. In this case, you can easily clone both. So we're going to take our 60 mile per hour run on this car, and we're going to come up with a new scenario. The geometry isn't changing, but some of the boundary conditions are. Everything is automatically copied. I simply come down and change whatever boundary condition I want as part of this new scenario. Very simple. Now, the next thing you may want to do is come up with a whole new design altogether. So basically, I need a geometry change. I'm going to make a pretty sexy car here. So I'm going to clone that entire design, including all of the scenarios that are under that design. And this is some pretty exciting new changes for CFdesign. So now you see, we're ready for whatever kind of design an Eagle Scout might come up with, instead of just the block. So we'll go back into SpaceClaim and make that happen. Now I'm not much of an artist, but SpaceClaim's going to make this pretty simple for me. So first I'll just sort of sketch out a little profile for something that looks a little more sporty. And then I'll hop into 3D and pull that right across. Now let's get a little more interesting here and add some curves to this car. Get a little bit more realism. Notice in SpaceClaim, if you select on a curve, it assumes you want to add a round. So you just pull. Design the way you think. Alright, that's starting to look pretty good. So now we're going to hop back into CFdesign. And you're going to notice how easy it is now to have all of our design options and all of these cloned scenarios under each ready to rock and roll. You'll notice that even though we've had a design change, all material properties are remembered, as is mesh sizing and boundary conditions. So all that's left really is to go in and run, actually solve each of these analyses and take advantage of the new decision center, which really warrants a whole video in itself. You've got to see some of the cool things. And finally, it wouldn't be a good demonstration of CFdesign without some particle tracing. And there are a lot of new cool things in there, but my favorite by far is the new comet solution for particles. And we'll take a look at that right now. Check that out. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this as my first look at CFdesign 2010. Really excited about where the tool is going. And I recommend you check it out at www.cfdesign.com.